This is Adi Sharma Solution, class 12, chapter 1, relation, exercises 1.1. So, I won't be able to show the question because that will be a copyright issue. So, I request you to have book in front of you so that we can discuss the questions as they come. Exercise is 1.1, the question number 1. Let A be the set of all human beings in a town at a particular time. So relation will always be on a set, and relation will have certain condition, and this will come out from A cross A. That is the Cartesian product of A cross A. Okay. Now we have Ram, Shyam, say Hassan, like this. I'm just naming them so we understand better. So this is the people, or you can say human beings in a town at a particular time. For example, on 12 January, 12 a.m., these many people are there in the town. Determine whether each of the following relations are reflexive, symmetric, and transitive. Reflexive means a single person is related to itself, that is, by the relation. Symmetric means if Ram is related to Shyam with the relation condition, the Shyam is also related with Ram with the same relation condition. And when we talk about transitive means if Ram is related to Shyam with certain condition of relation, and Shyam is related to Hassan, then Ram is related to Hassan. This is the transitivity. If Ram Shyam is in town, Shyam Hassan is in town, Ram and Hassan will be in the town. So the first part here, there are four parts. The first part, the relation is given like this. X, Y, this is the order pair. And this order pair should be such that X and Y work at the same place. Means if you have X, Y, X is first person, Y is second person, they both work at same place. This is the condition of the relation. So just assume that this X and Y are two people, two individuals. So X and Y work at same place. Okay. Now let us take one by one. Say I'm talking about Shyam. Now Shyam work at same place. If I say X, X, Shyam, and this is correct because Shyam is working at the same place as Shyam. Both Shyam, because if one Shyam is working, there is only one Shyam at this place. So other will also be the same Shyam. So this is with respect to this relation, this is reflexive. Okay. If you ask anybody else, who was here? Shyam. If you ask me, I'll say Shyam. So this is related. Now coming to symmetric. Now assume that Ram and Shyam, these two, say X or X and Y we are talking about, I'm giving you an example, real example. Now Ram and Shyam belongs to this relation. That is, Ram and Shyam are working at the same place. So if Ram and Shyam are working, Shyam and Ram will also be working because they both are same people. If you say Ram first, Shyam second, or Shyam first, Ram second, but they both are working at the same place, so it is symmetric. Coming to the transitivity. Now the same place, I'm talking about a place, they are working at the same place. So Ram and Shyam are working at say some place, and these two are true, then we have to talk about third one. So we are saying that Ram and Shyam is working at the same place, and Shyam and Hassan is also working at that place. Ram and Shyam say some mill they are working, and Shyam and Hassan are also working in that mill. So it is clear that Ram and Hassan is also working in that particular mill. So X and Y belongs to R. Y and Z belongs to R, this relation, so X and Z is also belonging to R. So this is an example, you have to write the way it is written in or printed in the left. You have to, this all is, I'm just giving an example to understand, okay? So I will be, the answers will be in front of you. I'm just going to give you the logic, how to understand the question and go about it if any, this kind of question comes in your exam. Or now the second one. In this second part of the first question. So relation you need to understand very well, otherwise the relation is X, Y. Relation will always be an ordered pair, and they will always be related by certain condition. X and Y live in the same locality. I'll just take the short form, right? Because writing will take a lot of time. So now X and Y live in the same locality. Say the locality name is Avas Vikas Colony, or say Vasant Vihar. So Ram and Shyam Hassan, again we are taking the same example to make you understand better. So X and Y are in the same locality. So if I am saying that Ram is living in this locality and somebody else come and he says Ram also stayed in the locality and there is only one person Ram in the locality. Let us take example of Hasan also. Hasan is related to itself because Hasan really lives in the locality and the locality has Hasan. Same thing. So this is a reflexive. Symmetric is Ram and Shyam is living in the locality. So when Ram Shyam is locality, they are living. So Shyam and Ram are also living in the locality because there is only one Ram. There is only one Shyam. Now transitivity. See, this is the locality. Ram and Shyam is living. This is what we have made it true. This is belonging to that relationship. And Shyam and Hasan. Shyam and Hasan is also living in this locality. This is what we are saying. So is it true that Ram and Hasan is also staying in the same locality? Yes. There is only one Ram, there is only one Shyam, there is only one Hasan. So if Ram and Shyam is there, Shyam and Hasan is there, Ram and Hasan is also there. If XY belongs to R and YZ belongs to R, that means XZ belong to R. They both are living in the same society or same locality. So this is transitive also. Now the third part of the first question. Okay, this is somewhat true, tricky, okay? I'll just tell you that why it is not what we think. So X is wife of Y. See, in the first view, we will be able to understand that this is neither of all these three relations. But let us take example of Ram, Shyam and Hasan. Now take example of a woman also, Pooja, say. So take the example of Ram. So Ram is a wife of Ram. Is it possible? Can a man be a wife of himself? No. Take example of Hasan. Can Hasan be his wife? No. So it is not reflexive. Symmetric. Now let us take example of say X, Y. If X is wife of Y, then Y is a wife of X. Is it possible? If XY is true, X should also be true. Say, let us take Shyam and now take the example of Pooja. Let us take one more person in this set. Let us assume that she is the wife of Shyam. So Shyam, Pooja. Now Shyam, so this X is Pooja and Y is Shyam. So Pooja is wife of Shyam. So now is it true that Shyam is... If Pooja is wife of Shyam, Shyam is also wife of Pooja. No, Shyam is the husband of Pooja. So if first is true, second cannot be true. One is male, one is female. So one can be wife of another, the other person can only be husband of other. Okay. Now third part. As I told you, it is not symmetric, it is not reflexive. Let us come to the third one. It is quite evident that it is not a transitive relation. But I'll prove it that it is a transitive relation. I will prove it that it is a transitive. Okay. How it is transitive? See. In transitive, we assume and we say that if XY belongs to R and YZ belongs to R, XZ also belongs to R. This is transitive relation. The first we assume to be true and third if we get, then we say it is transitive. But you see here, if I take XYZ, YZ. Now X and Y. X is Pooja, Y is say Shyam. So Pooja is wife of Shyam. We assume this. That is XY belongs to R. Okay. Now coming to the second one. YZ belongs to R. This is what we are saying. It is true. But this cannot be true. Why? Because Shyam cannot be a wife of Ram. Pooja can be wife of Shyam. But Shyam cannot be wife of Ram. So YZ is not belonging to R. XY, because we have to say XY belong to R, YZ belong to R, this has to be true, then only XZ belongs to R. So the second condition fails, it can never be true. So when the second condition, either of these, when it fails, whether the third condition, the transitive condition fails or not. Because the second condition by itself is fail. It by itself failed. So if comma X, comma Z, is it true or not? See, Pooja and Ram. Pooja is not the wife of Ram. Pooja is the wife of Shyam. So Pooja is the wife of Ram is also incorrect. What I am saying is, these two conditions has to be true. Then if third condition holds, then we say that it is transitive. But the first condition is true. Second condition cannot be true in this particular relation. So the second is failed. So third is also failed. So that is how it is a transitive relation. Now this is question number 2. Three relations R1, R2 and R3 are defined on a set A, which is, this fourth one is remaining. So let me take fourth first. R is XY, X is the father of Y. Now see reflexive. Can anybody father of himself? Can Satish be father of Satish? No. Symmetric. If, let us take three of them. Satish, Ramesh. Now Satish is the father of Ramesh. So is Ramesh also father of Satish? No. No. So it is not symmetric also. One is father, so one has to be son. Now coming to the third one, X, Y, Z. Now let us take three. Now X is a Y. X is a father of Y. X is a father of Y. Now this is holding. This is holding. Now Y, Z is also holding. So now the Y is father of Z. So there is a son whose father, which is Z. Y is father and X is the father of Y. So he is grandfather. So when this condition is there, is X, Z also belongs to that relation? That is, if X is the father of Z, no, X is the grandfather of Z. So X, Z is not coming to X, is not the father of Y, X is the grandfather of Y. Now this is question number 2. Okay. There are three relations, R1, R2 and R3 are defined on set A, which is A, B, C. These are like this. Now see here. So this is a set. Every relation is on a set. And relations will have certain condition. So first relation is A, A, B, A, C. These are all ordered pairs. B, B, C, C, A, C, B, and C, C. Okay. So B, 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 C, C, A, C, B, C. Okay. Now, there are four parts here again, because we have to tell whether this R1 is equivalence or not. That is, whether it is reflexive symmetric, this one and R1. So AA is there. A is related to A. BB is there. CC is there. So it is reflexive. Okay. Every element is related to itself. Now symmetric. Now if AB is there, BA should be there. So let us see AB is there or not. If AB is belonging to that relation, BA should also belong to that relation. So see here AB, yes. And AB is there, BA is there or not? B is there or not? See, BA. No. BA is not there. BA is not there. See, AC is there, CA is there. And CB is there, BC is there. But if you see here, AB is there, BA is not there. I couldn't find BA. No. So that means, if you see the question of R.D. Sharma, it is saying that it is not symmetric. So it is not symmetric. Please, I am cancelling it. Please remember, it is not symmetric. Because AB is there, BA is not. I couldn't find BA. Not transitive. See, A, A are transitive. Because if you assume A to be X and the second X to be Y. So if XY is there, YX is there or not? Because X, we have assumed A, Y as A. So this is also A, A. So if AA is there, it is reflexive. It is transitive also. So AA, BB, CC, BC as transitive. Now, the condition of transitivity is there, which is saying A, B belongs to R. And B, C belongs to R. If these two are true, AC should be there. Then it will be transitive. So is it AC? Yes. AB is there, BC is there, AC is also there. So it is transitive also. This is not symmetric. Okay, remember it. Now coming to the R2. There are four relations. R2 is A, A. There is only one ordered pair, A, A. Now this is quite clear, which we discussed just now. It is reflexive, it is symmetric, and it is transitive also. It is symmetric, it is reflexive, it is transitive. The logic is same as we just gave in the last question. How it is? Because this AA can be taken as xy, can be taken as yz, can be taken as xz. Okay, so let us start with the reflexive. Okay, reflexive is every element should be related to A because the set is ABC. So A is related to A comma A is in this set. This A comma is the ordered pair. So A is related to A is there. It is there in the set. This is a set. So A is ABC and A is related to A. So it is, if A is there, then it is reflexive. Now coming, so it is reflexive. So it is reflexive, right? Now symmetric, is it symmetric? A comma A, assume it to be X, other one to be Y. We don't know what is there. Just assume X and Y. So whether YX is there, place Y as A and X is also. So A is there, A also there. So A is there, XY is there, Y is X is there. Now coming to the transitive, assume it to be XYZ. So XY is there, Y is Z is there, then XZ should be there. So now AA, assume it to be XY. So since Y is already we have assumed to be A, so let us A, take it as Z, assume it to be A. So we are maintaining it to be true. So whether XZ is true or not, because X we have taken as A, Z also assumed as A, so A is also already there, so transitive also. So it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive at the same time. Now coming to R3. R3 is saying B, C. So it's quite clear. It is neither of them. Okay. Why? It is neither of them. Why it is not neither of them? Okay. See. So A, A is related to A. Not there. BC is there. So CB should be there. It is not there. Not symmetric. Since there are only two elements. For transitive, you need three. So by default, we assume it to be transitive. See, when there is no data given, we assume it to be transitive. So this is transitive. Now R4. R4 is saying, these are all coming from the set A, B, C. This is the only set we have. Now R4 is A, B, B, C, and C, A. A, B, B, C, C, A. Now see, first, whether AA is there, BB is there, CC is there. Is it there? AA, BB, CC, are you able to find it in this relation? No, so it is not reflexive. If AB is there, now coming to symmetric. If AB is there, BA is there? No. If BC is there, CB is there? No. If CA is there, AC is there? No. So it is not symmetric. XY is there, YX should be there. Now coming to transitive. AB is there. And BC is there. So XY, AB is there. So this is XY. And BC, YZ is there. So AC is there or not? XZ. No, it is not there. Only CA is there. So it is not transitive also. So this is question number 3. Test whether the following relations R1, R2, R3 are reflexive, symmetric, transitive. So we have to find out for all these. There are 3 subparts here. So first one I am taking right now, R1 on Q0. So what is this Q0? Q0 is a rational number without a zero, a non-zero rational number. That is P by Q form. Let me tell you again, Q0 is a set, will be of A by B or P by Q form, and B and Q or any will not be equal to zero. And defined by A comma B, always the relation will have an ordered pair and there will be a relation. So A relation is given by A equals 1 by B. A equals 1 by B. Okay. So let us start with the first one, reflexive. Reflexive means the A should be related to A. That is, always in any relation of this kind, means any condition of this kind, just replace B by A and find out whether it holds or not. A is 1 by A? No. Is it possible? 2 is equal to 1 by 2? No. Right? Even if you take 1, 1 by 1 is okay. If you take 1, it is. I'm just giving you a case that is possibility is still seen. But what I'm suggesting here is, broader case, A equals 1 by A will never hold. So because of this, what do we say? That it is not reflexive, because 5 equals 1 by 5 is not possible at all. If you take a proper P by Q, it will not hold. Now symmetric, A and B is there, that is this A comma B ordered pair is in the relation, in relation R1. B, A should also be this in this relation. So that means A is 1 by B and B by A is B should be 1 by A. So this is going to give you AB, A into B equals 1. Or you can say B equals 1 by A, both are same. You can also say AB equals 1, AB equals 1, both holds. So this is symmetric. So it is symmetric. Now coming to transitive. So transitive means if AB belongs to this R1 and BC also belongs to this R1, then AC should be in this relation. We are assuming this AB BC holds. Okay, A is 1 by B, AB is holding. So A is 1 by B and BC is holding. That means B equals 1 by C. So from this we have to get AC also holds in this relation. So you can just write it as, say, AB or BA equals 1. This you can write it as BC equals 1. You can divide them. So BA by BC equals 1 by 1. You can cancel this AC. So A by C equals 1. So A equals C. You're not getting A equals 1 by C. Okay? You're getting A equals C. So that means the transitivity does not hold because you're getting A equals C. And what you should get? A equals 1 by C. So it is not transitive. It is not transitive. The second one is R2. This is a second relation. So this is a relation on the set. And what is the set? Set is Z. Z are integers. Integers are basically negative and positive integral values along with a zero. You don't have real number here. So A and B belongs to, first is this A and B belongs to R2 such that the condition of this relation is A minus B, which is modulus of A minus B, should be less than or equal to 5. So reflexive is A related to A. So A, just put B as A, as I said. Just replace. See, in reflexive and symmetric, it's quite easy because if you are relation, just put B as A. So A minus A, and this is mod A minus A, 0, 0 is less than or equal to 5. So 0 is actually less than or equal to 5. So this is reflexive. So this is reflexive. Now coming to symmetric. Now symmetric means what? If AB is belonging to this relation R2, BA should belong to this relation. Just make A minus B and B minus A. See, A minus B and B minus A doesn't matter because there is a modulus sign. A minus B, B minus A, it doesn't matter because there is a modulus sign. Always positive will come. Let me take any number here. Or you can try a number also. Or you just see here A minus B and B minus A are equal. So 1 minus 2, 2 minus 1. 1 minus 2 mod is minus 1, mod is 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. 2 minus 1 is 1. So both the time you are going to get it as less than or equal to 5 because of the virtue of modulus, absolute value. So R2 is symmetric. Okay. Please remember, I am talking about Z. You have to keep your eye on this set on which this relation is defined. I am taking a big number here. 52 minus 36, 36 minus 52. I'm just taking a bigger number just to make you understand that if you see, this is 4, 36 minus this is, I've taken a random number, so it's 4 plus 2. Okay, 16 will come. So this will be 16, this is minus 16, take the modulus, you're going to get 16 only. So this less than or equal to 5, is it there? In both the cases, they are not less than 5. So both the cases. So I am suggesting here is that they both should hold, A related to B or B related to A. Otherwise, they shouldn't hold together. Then you can say they are symmetric. Both the cases you have to see. Now coming to the transitivity. So the best way of transitivity, when you are not very convinced with how to get it done by the condition which is given. So better is to give the numbers. So we have already seen this symmetricity. So now we are coming to the transitivity. So AB, BC we are taking. So A minus B less than equal to is less than equal to 5. B minus C less than equal to 5. So how to find this? There are a number of ways we can do it, but the easiest way is to take the number. Just to prove it, you can take the number. There is no problem. Okay. Examiner will give you total max. So 1 minus 3 is less than or equal to 5. You are going to take modulus. So it is going to give you 2. 2 is less than 5. 3 and 7. 3 minus 7 is what? It's minus 4. Modulus is 4. 4 is less than or equal to 5. But if you say A and C, that is 1 and 7. 1 minus 7 modulus is 6. 6 is not less than or equal to 5. It is greater than or equal to 5. So it is not transitive. So we just took an example. Numbers. So it is not transitive. So now we are checking the reflexivity. So this is R3, which is defined on what? On real numbers. So it can have a decimal value also. Now this is defined by A, B, and this is belonging to this R3. And this implies the condition is A square minus 4AB plus 3B squared is equal to 0. So let us start with our reflexivity. So A should be related to A. Now just put A as B. A as B. So A square minus 4A. Now put B as A plus 3B as A. So you have A square minus 4A square plus 3A square. 3A square plus A square is 4A square. 4A square minus 4A square is 0. So you get a reflexive here. Now coming to the second one. This is the transit. This is not transitive. This is symmetric. So if AB is belonging to R, BA should belong to R. So just replace A by B and B by A. This is what you have to do in every question which is coming. So A square minus 4AB plus 3B square. This is AB is holding. Now replace or change A to B and B to A. So it will become B square minus 4AB or 4BA plus 3A square. But now you see here, because it is defined on the R real numbers, they both are not same. They are not, first of all, they are not same. The discussion about zero comes later. They are not equal only. Even if one is zero, the other will not be. So that is, these two have to be, first they have to be seen as same. Then only we can talk about others. So it is not symmetric. We were talking about symmetric. Now third one is transitivity. So transitivity, as I said, if I put A, B, B, C and then A, C, that will be very difficult. Okay. So, A square minus 4AB plus 3B square is there. So, as I said, putting A, B, B, C, A, C will be difficult. So, better is to put the values. So, let us start with 1, 2. So, 1, 2, put A as 1 and B as 2. So, what do you get? 1 square minus 4 into 1 into 2 plus 3 into 2 square. So 1 minus 8 plus 12, 12 plus 1 is 13, 13 minus 8 is 5. See, here you get 5, not 0. Coming to the other one, 2, 3. Now I'm taking B as 2 and C as 3. So what do you get? First we didn't get 0, please remember. Now I'm putting 2 and 3. What do you get when you put 2 and 3? Again, I'm putting A as 2 and B as 3. So 2 squared minus 4 into 2 into 3 plus 3 into 3 square. 4 minus 4 to 9, 8 is 24 plus 3 to 9, 9 is 27. Okay. So this is minus 20 plus 27. You are going to get 7 here. See again, it is 7. It is not equal to 0. Now, when you take 1 and 3, it should not be equal to 0. Because we have taken AB, it is not equal to 0. We have taken BC, it is not equal to 0. If you get A, this 1, 3 not equal to 0, then it is transitive, otherwise not. So just put A as 1 and B as 3 and 1 square minus 12 plus 9, 9 is a 27. So you get 27, 28 minus 12, 20 minus 12 is 16. Okay. Now you see, this is also not equal to 0. So what is the conclusion? The conclusion is very clear. When AB is giving you non-zero, BC is giving you non-zero, and AC is also giving you non-zero, that means, can you tell it is transitive? You can tell it is transitive. It is transitive. This is the clear logic. If A and B is zero, B and C is zero, but AC will not give you zero, that is, it is not transitive. But AB is not zero, BC is not zero, but AC is going to give you a this in this case is not equal to 0. So it is transitive. I hope you got my logic. right? Sometimes we only have two values, and there is no third value. So we cannot check transitive. At that time also, we always take it as a transitive because there are only two values. The question is not giving us third value. So how can we find out? So we just say it is transitive, right? Okay, most of the discussions are on this. They just gave A, B, B, C and they just said that it is not. But my logic is both are positive. Third also came positive. So it is transitive. If it is not, then it is non-transitive. Okay, question number 4 we are taking. Now let A equals 1, 2, 3. And there are certain relations being given here. So R1, R2, R3 is given. Find whether or not each of the relation R1, R2, R3 is reflexive, symmetric or transitive. So let us start with R1. R1 is what? 1, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1, 2, 2, 2, 1 and 3, 3. Okay. So let me check it again. 1, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1, 2, 2, 2, 1 and 3, 3. Okay. Now see, reflexivity. For reflexive, A should be related to A. So 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 should be there. Let us see whether 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is there, is not. It is there. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is there. So it is reflexive. Symmetric. If AB is there, BA should be there. Okay. So you see, 1, 3 is there. 1, 1 is there. So 1, 1 is there. 1, 3 is there. 3, 1 is there. Yes. 2, 1 is there. 1, 2 is not there. 2, 1 is there. 1, 2 is not there. So it is not symmetric. Okay. AB is there. BA should also be there. Because 1, 3 and 3, 1 are there. 2, 1 and 1, 2 is not there. That is why we deny it. Now coming to transitivity. Now A is related to B, B is related to C, A related to C. So we have 1, 3, 3, 1 is there. So 1, 1 is there. 1, 3, 3, 1 is there. And 1, 3, 3, 3. So 1, 3, 1, 3, 3, 3, 3. 1, 3, 3, 3, so 1, 3 is there. Okay. So 2, 2, 2, 1, 2, 2, 2, 2, 1. So 2, 1 should be there. 2, 2, 2, 1. Okay. So what I'm trying to suggest here is 1, 1, 3. Okay. So I'm just saying 1, 3, 3, 1, A, B, B, C. I'm taking one of the example. 1, 3, 3, 1. So 1, 3, 3, 1. So A, C. So 1, 1 is also there. 2, 2, 2, 1. So 2, 1 is also there. 2, 2, 2, 1, 2, 1 is also there. So this is transitive. Next one is this R2. R2 is 2, 2, 3, 1 and 1, 3. 2, 2, 3, 1 and 1, 3. Okay. Now let us see reflexive. What do you want? 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Reflexive, A should be related to A. So 2, 2 is there. Bus 1, 1 and 3, 3 is not there. 1, 1, 3, 3 is not there. So 2, 2 is there. So this is not reflexive. It is not reflexive. Clear? Because you need 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 should be there. Okay. Now coming to the next one. Symmetric. So 2, 2 is there. It is symmetric. 3, 1 is there. 1, 3 is there. If AB is there, so it is symmetric also. BA is also there. So transitive. See, 3, 1 is there and 1, 3 is there. So you have to have 3, 3. A is related to B, B is related to C. So you should get A related to C. So 3, 1 is there. 1, 3 is there. You should get 3, 3. There is no 3, 3. Not transitive. Now coming to the R3. R3 is 1, 3 and 3, 3. So 1, 3. Okay. Now it's very clear. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is not there. So it is not reflexive. Only 3, 3 is there. 1, 1, 2, 2 is not there. So it is not reflexive. Symmetric. 1, 3 is there. 3, 1 is not there. So it is not symmetric as well. Third one. Transitive. 1, 3, AB and 3, 3, BC. So 1, 3, 3, 3 is there. So 1, 3 is also there. So it is transitive. That is A related to B. 1, 3 I am writing. Here 3, 3. So we should get AB, BC, or AC should be there. So 1, 3 should be there. And it is there. So it is transitive. It is not reflexive, not symmetric, it is transitive.
So, question number 5.
Okay. The following relation are defined on the set of real numbers. A or B. A is related to B if A minus B is greater than 0. Okay. So, if we are taking A, comma B, A related to B should only be when A minus B should be greater than 0. So, whether they are these relation, there are three parts, reflexive, symmetric or transitive. So, the first one, whenever you have to check the reflexive, just put B as A. A minus A is greater than 0, 0 is greater than 0, no. No. 0 cannot be greater than 0. So, it is not reflexive. Symmetric, just replace A by B, B by A. So, if A minus B is greater than 0, B minus A is greater than 0, B minus is greater than 0, no. If you want to check it, just multiply negative 1, both sides. So, whenever you multiply negative value, the inequality will change. So, it will be minus B minus A greater than 0, less than 0. And minus B minus A is A minus B only. So, minus B minus minus plus. So, A minus B is less than 0. So, one time you are getting A minus B greater than 0. Other time you are getting A minus B less than 0, which is contradictory. Okay. This is contradiction. So, it is not symmetric as well. It is not reflexive, neither symmetric. Coming to transitivity. A minus B is greater than 0 and B minus C is greater than 0. You should get A minus C greater than 0. Okay. Now, this is 1, this is 2. Now, just you can either add them because B, B will cancel. Just add these two. So, A minus B plus B minus C greater than 0. B, B cancels. A minus C is greater than 0, which is the quite a result. So, it is transitive. It is transitive. Now, the next one is A is related to B if and only if 1 plus AB is greater than 0. 1 plus AB is greater than 0. So, let us start with the reflexive. And I told you reflexive, just replace B by A. Wherever B is there, replace A by A. So, 1 plus A dot A is greater than 0. 1 plus A square is greater than 0. A square, negative, positive, whatever you put, it will always be positive. And you are adding 1 to positive value, it will be greater than 0. What I am trying to suggest here is, even if you take minus value, minus square will be positive. So, positive plus 1 is always greater than 0. Coming to symmetricity. Okay. Just replace A by B and B by A. 1 plus AB holds. And let us see, 1 plus BA also holds or not. So, I am replacing A by B, B by A. Oh, they both are same. They are absolutely same. So, 1 plus AB only. The second line is 11 plus AB only. Okay. So, this is symmetric also. Now, transitivity. So, what we are going to see, AB and B and C. Now, we will have to check for A and C. So, let us take A as minus 1. I am just randomly taking the numbers and this is just a hit and trial I have done. So, A I am taking it as minus 1, B as half, C as 2. So, let us check for first one, A 1 plus AB. So, 1 minus half, that is going to be half. Half is greater than 0. This is absolutely correct. Now, coming to BC. 1 plus BC, I'm multiplying half with 2. So this is 2 cancels, 2 is greater than 0. So this is also correct. Now, if I get A and C, if it is greater than 0, then we say transitive, otherwise not. So now 1 plus A is minus 1 and C is 2. So 1 minus 2, and that is going to be minus 1, and minus 1 is less than 0. That is, it is less than 0. So it is not transitive. Now, next one is A is related to B if mod A, mod is absolute value, whatever you put, it will come as positive, is less than equal to B. So, I will take an example here. See, if I put here minus 2, I am checking reflexive. So, minus 2 mod is less than equal to minus 2. Minus 2, 2 is less than equal to minus 2 because mod 2 is less than equal to minus 2. No, it is not reflexive. Now, symmetric. If mod A is less than equal to B, mod B should be also less than equal to A. Again, we'll take an example. Let us take A as 4, B as 8. So, we are taking 4 less than equal to this 8. So, 4 is less than equal to 8. Let us see 8. 8 modulus is 8 only. Less than equal to 4. No. So, first is correct. The second is wrong. So, it is not symmetric. Now, coming to transitive. So, transitive, I'm taking 2, 4, 6. Just random numbers.
2, 4, 6. So mod A is like less than equal to B. So 2 is less than equal to 4. That is correct. And now 4 and 6 I'm taking. B is less than equal to C. 4 is less than equal to 6. Yes, this is absolutely correct. And now coming to A and C. So I'm taking A as 2 and C as 6. So 2 mod 2 is 2 only. 2 is less than equal to this 6. So this is also, this is correct. So this is transitive. Okay. This is transitive. So you can, it is neither reflexive nor symmetric, but it is transitive. Whenever you have any problem, just use numbers. Numerals you can take. Because this kind of, sometimes it is very difficult to explain using the expressions. But expression is always advisable. But numbers can also be taken. In some of the books I've seen, they have given this mod A is less than equal to B. Mod B is less than equal to C. Multiply these two, mod A into mod B. Both sides, mod B equals B into C. Less than equal to B into C. And BB they cancelled. I don't know how because it is mod. Anyways, what they have given is I'm trying to just explain. Mod A is less than equal to C. This is how they have explained. But I'm not very much convinced how they have done this. But with numbers, I've checked. So it is coming all right. So it is transitive. Foolproof. So this is question number 6. Check whether the relation R defined on the set A and A is given by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 as, let me write the set first. It's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. And the relation which is given is like this relation. Relation is always a condition. So this ordered pair have to fulfill A, comma B. Where B is equal to A plus 1. Now the important thing is this is a NCERT question. So whether it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive, let us start with reflexive. In reflexive, I told you wherever B is there, put A. Okay, both will be A. So A is A plus 1. Is it possible? Never. So this cannot be true ever. Just take an example, put 2. Take any value 2, 2 plus 1, 2 not equal to 3. Now this is not reflexive, coming to symmetricity. Symmetric. Now symmetric is also quite easy. Just replace A with B, B with A. So now just B equals A plus B. So I am putting A, B here. Now B, A will be A equals B plus 1. A equals B plus 1. Now there are multiple ways to prove that it is not symmetric. That is, either you can find B from here. From the second one or A from the first one, either ways. So let us find A from the first one. A is equal to B minus 1. Now, one is A equals B minus 1, the other is A is B plus 1. So this is a contradiction. A cannot be simultaneously B plus 1 and B minus 1. So if A, B is there, B is not there. So it is not symmetric either. Coming to the transitivity. Now in transitivity, see, the good way is always to use the formula or the expression or the condition. But a not so good one is giving the values. But the last resort is always giving values. So let us take AB as 1, 2 and BC as 2, 3. So when A and B and C are holding, this relation is holding, A and C should hold. That is, B is A plus 1 and here the B is A plus 1, so C is B plus 1. So 2 is equal to 1 plus 1. And here, since C is equal to B plus 1. So 3 is equal to 2 plus 1. So what do you see here? That I am putting in B equals A plus 1 first A and B. And then in B equals A plus 1, I am putting B and C. That is, in place of A, I am putting B. In place of B, I am putting C. So 3 is equal to 2 plus 1. 3 is equal to 3. So 2 is equal to 2 and 3 equal to 3. So our two conditions are true. Third condition we have to meet. Now, whether A and C is following or not, now B is A plus 1, so what you have to do is, in place of A, put A, in place of B, put C, okay? In place of A, keep it A, in place of B, put C. So B is A plus 1, B is C 3, basically C I have written. So 3 equals to 1 plus 1, 3 is not equal to 2. So A is related to B, B is related to, but C plus A is not related to C. That is, it is not transitive. I'll tell you one more method here, just to, you know, make it more impressive. In order to As I said, number giving is always an option. But first, we have to see the option where we can use the expression and then solve the question. Then we can tell the examiner that this is how we have done. We know how to do the expression work. Okay. So B is A plus 1 here. And B is A plus 1. And here, what is this? B and C. So C is equal to B plus 1. That is going to be C equals B plus 1. Now see here. Now A is A and C. That means we need an expression which is C equals A plus 1 from these two. First two, I need C equals A plus 1. Is it possible? Can we do it? We can try it. C is A plus 1. So C is A plus 1. So C is coming B plus 1. Now let us find B. So can you put B here? B is equal to A plus 1. A plus 1 plus 1. A plus 2. Or A is equal to C minus 1, you can put. A is C minus 1 from here. So when you put C minus 1 here, this is going to be, I am putting A as C minus 1 here. Okay. So what do I get? B is C minus 1 is A one time. C, this C minus 1 is B one time. And that is not possible. Right? That is, either way you can do. You can find A and C together also. Question number 7 here. Now the important thing is, this is a NCERT question. Along with this, this is a CBSE 2010. This has come also. So it's an important question. Okay. So we have to check whether, the relation R on capital R is a real number. This is real number. Defined by R equals A comma B colon A is less than equal to BQ. Is reflexive, symmetric or transitive? So reflexive, symmetric and transitive. Okay. Reflexive is what? As I said, put A as A. A as A. So A is less than equal to A cube. Is it possible? Just put example. Half. Half is less than equal to 1 by 8. No. Half is 0.5. 1 by 8 is half of 0.25. Right. So half is not less than or equal to 1 by 8. In fact, 1 by 8 is less than or equal to half. So this is not reflexive. We just use the numbers. Now coming to the second one, which is symmetric. Symmetric, now we'll take example. I am taking A. A if it is related to B and B is related to A. So I am taking A as 1 and B as 3 raised to the power 1 by 3. Why we have taken? Because it's cube. A is less than or equal to B cube. So that is why we have taken cube root. Just because the power 3 will be cancelled. This is how we have taken these two numbers. Now A, 1 is A is less than equal to B cube. So 1 is less than or equal to 3 raised 1 by 3 whole cube. So 1 is this 3 and 1 by 3 cancels out. So 1 is less than or equal to 3. Yes, this is correct. Now, when we have A related to B, whether B is related to A, now this B is 3 raised to the power 1 by 3. Is it less than or equal to 1 cube? So 3 raised 1 by 3 is cube root of 3, which is in fact 1.44. And is 1.44 less than or equal to 1? 1 cube is 1. No, it's not. So it is not symmetric either. It is not reflexive, not symmetric. Let us check for the transitivity. So transitivity again will take numbers. I'm taking A as 5, B as 2, and 3, this C as 2 raised 1 by 3. Again, why 2 raised 1 by 3 or cube root of 2? Because cube will cancel out. Cube will cancel out this. So A, B, C. A is, so let us see. 5 is less than or equal to 2 cube. A and B I'm checking. So 5 less than or equal to 8, this is absolutely okay. Now B and C. See, A and B is correct, B and C is correct. We have to get A and C to be correct. So B and C, let us take B and C. So B less than or equal to, so 2 less than or equal to 2 raised 1 by 3 cube. Okay, 2 less than or equal to 2 raised 1 by 3 whole cube. This 2 is less than or equal to this 2. So 2 is not less than, but it is equal. So this is also correct. Now let us check A and C, whether we are getting it or not. Okay. So 5 is less than or equal to 2 raised 1 by 3 whole cube. 5 less than or equal to cube 1 by 3 cancels. 5 less than or equal to 2. No, this is incorrect. This is not even transitive. Question number 8 I am taking. Prove that every identity relation on a set is reflexive, but the converse is not necessarily true. So what is an identity relation? Identity relation is the set which has all the elements of the set related to itself. That is, if I take an example of A, which is 1, 2, 3. So identity relation, let me make a set form, then you will be able to understand more. So this is A cross A, because we are talking about relation. So this is 1, 2, 3, this is also 1, 2, 3. So A cross A, the identity relation will be 1, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3. 1, 1, 2, 2 and 3, 3. Only this one, nothing else. Okay, this is the identity relation on the set. So a relation, I'm taking A as 1, 2, 3. I'm making a relation which is 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 along with 2, 1 and 1, 3. So 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is there. So it is a reflexive, because every element is related to itself. And the question is asking, the converse is not true. See, this is a reflexive relation, but this is not an identity relation, because identity is only 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Because in identity, A, A should belong to I. So this particular relation which we have chosen is a reflexive relation, but this reflexive relation is not an identity relation, because identity relation is 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. I hope you got the idea. The relation we have taken is by itself we have taken as reflexive, but we wanted to prove it that the converse is not true. Question number 9 now. A is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4. Define relations on A which have properties of being. Okay. So you see here, we have made 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 1, 2. The 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is reflexive. No. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4. So, reflexive it is. Now coming to transitive. No, symmetric let us take first. So symmetric. 1, 2. 2, 1 should be there. 1, 2, 2, 1 should be there. So it is not symmetric. We proved it to be symmetric. Non-symmetric. Let us take some transitive now. So 1, 1, 1, 2. 1, 1 is there. 1, 2 is there. A, B, B, C. So 1, 2 should be there. And it is there. A, B, B, C, A, C should be there. So this relation is reflexive, transitive, but not symmetric. Now second one we have to give symmetric, but neither reflexive nor transitive. Symmetric. So we have made 1, 2 and 2, 1. 1, 2 and 2, 1. So 1, 2, 2, 1. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is not there. So it is not reflexive. This is quite clear. It is not reflexive. Then coming to symmetric. Now first let us see transitive. 1, 2, 2, 1. So 1, 1 should be there. This is A, B. This is A, B. A, B, B, C. 1, 1 should be there. 1, 1 is not there. So it is not transitive either. What about transitive? 1, 2 is there. So 2, 1 is also there. A, B is there. B, A is also there. So this is symmetric, but neither reflexive nor transitive. Third one. Reflexive, symmetric and transitive. So 1, 2 is there. Just add 2, 1. See, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. Will give you it's being reflexive. 1, 2 is there, 2, 1 is there. 1, 1, 1, 2, 2, 1 is there, it is transitive. 1, 2, 2, 1 is there. So 1, 1 should be there. A, B, B, C. So A, C should be there. 1, 1 is also there. So it is reflexive, symmetric and transitive also. I hope you got the idea. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4 is reflexive. 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 1 is what we are being seeing till now. Question number 10. Let R be a relation defined on a set of natural number n. Now, this is very important. Natural numbers are counting numbers. In this question, all is depending on this natural, being natural. So, the relation is given by x, y. X and y belongs to this natural number. And 2x plus y equals 41 is given. So, as I told you, if A or B you take, x or y you take, whichever you take. The first one in the ordered pair is always domain. The second one is called range. So since x is already given as natural number, we know that domain is natural number. This is clear? Now coming to y. How to find y from this expression? Take 2x on the right hand side. So y will be 41 minus 2x. So y equals 41 minus 2x. And what we'll do? Let us take the value of x. We start with 1. Because x starts, the natural number x starts from 1. So I'm putting x as 1. 41 minus 2 into 1, I'm putting in this y.
equals 21 minus 2x, x is 1. So it is going to be 39. Now I'm putting x as 2. 41 minus 2 into 2, that is going to be 37. And I go up to x equals 20. So this will be 20. I'll tell you why I have come up to 20. 41 minus 2 into 20, 41 minus 40, that is going to be 1. Now coming to 21, 41 minus 2 into 21, 41 minus, this is 42. No, 42. So this 41 minus 42 is minus 1. But this minus 1 is not a natural number. So we cannot have x equals 20. We can only go up from x1 till x20. Okay? So now the domain becomes 1 to 20. Domains become 1 to 20 because x has been restricted. And now y is 1, 3. Either you write like this. This start from 39 till 1. Or you can start from 1, 3, 5. It's not 2, okay? 1, 3. There's a, I'll just change it. 1, 3 till 39. Okay? Now let us check reflexive. You see, reflexive, you take any value. You put any value from 1 to 20. Now x can only be put as 1 to 20. So let us take x and y both as 2 because both are coming in this. So x equals y. So 2x plus x equals 41. So 3x equals 41. X equals 41 by 3. No, 41 by 3 is not a natural number. So this is contradiction. And you can take the example also. You can put 2, 2. 2 into 2 is 4 plus 2 is 6. So 6 is not equal to 41. This is not reflexive. Now coming to symmetric. Symmetric is A related to this A related to B. B should relate to A. So 2x plus y equals 41. And 2x plus y equals 41. And 2y plus x equals 41. So I'll just change it. It is not y plus 2x. So let us see here. See 2x plus y equals 41. Let me write it again. And then I'll multiply this and try to solve this x and y. And then we'll prove the contradiction. That is 2x plus y equals 41. And we are 2y plus x equals 41. These are two equations. I've just placed x, y as yx. So multiplying first equation by 2, you get 4x plus 2y. 41 into 2 is 82. Now this is 2y plus x. So I'm just taking x here and 2y, and this is 41. Now let us subtract it. 4x minus x is 3x. 2y, 2y gets cancelled. 82 minus 41, that is 41. So x is 41 by 3. So now you see x is again 41 by 3. So this is also a contradiction. X can never be 41 by 3. It's a natural number. So it is not symmetric also. Now I'm just clearing it because I want to prove that it is, whether it is transitive or not. So let us check for transitive and we'll take an example here. You can also take this expression, but better is to use because the expression will grow the time to solve this. So I'm taking AB as 15, 11. So 2 into this x is 15 plus y is 11. So you get 30 plus 11, that is 41. 41 is equal to 41. Okay, A and B we have chosen correctly. Now B and C we are choosing 11 and 19. So I'm placing B as 11 and C as 90, that is x as 11 and this is 19. So 2 into 20, 11, 22 plus 19 is 41. 41 equals 41. So this AB and BC choice is correct, which we have chosen. So AB, BC, when we have found it to be correct, we need to have AC also. So now put A and C. So 2 into 15, I'm taking A and in place of Y, I'm putting C. So 2 into 15 plus 19, that is 30 plus 19, 49. 49 is not equal to 41. That is untrue. So this is not transitive. 49 is not equal to 41. So it is not transitive either. Now question number 11. Is it true that every relation which is symmetric and transitive is also reflexive? Give reasons. Okay, if you see in your hint, they have given some certain thing. I'll take another one, which we already done. So it is A is equal to ABC. The relation I'm making is A comma A. Now you see, every relation which is symmetric and transitive is also reflexive. I'll prove it otherwise. It is symmetric. AA, the relation is symmetric. If I take it as XY, YX will be what? Just put X and Y. So Y is also A and X is also A. So A is also there. We started with XY. YX is also A. So this is First, this is first one. Not this is we have proved it to be symmetric, not transitive. See, there are only two values. There is nothing, no third value. So by default, we assume it to be transitive. When there are only two, we are not having the third one. We assume it to be transitive. Okay. To be reflexive, it has to have BB and CC, because reflexive AA, BB, CC should be there. So we prove it to be symmetric. We prove it to be transitive, but we have proved that, and we see also it is not reflexive. That is why it is not true. Other examples also you can choose. Okay. Now the next question here is question number 12. So we have M related to N, and how this is related? There is a condition properly given. M is a multiple of N. M is a multiple of N. That is, we will take some constant, say K. M equals KN, like 4 is equal to 2 into 2 like this, or 6 equal to 3 into 2 like this. K is belonging to the natural number. Okay. So check if the relation is symmetric, reflexive and transitive. So first condition is what? As I said, A and B, it is always, we have been using A and B, but here just A is given by M and B is given by N. So for reflexive, if we assume M and N by A and B, we'll just change or put B as A. So just put M in place of N. So M equals KM. This is also possible. K can be 1. M by, if you divide both sides by M, K can be 1. Okay. M equals M. So it is reflexive. Second we are checking is a symmetric. This is not T. This is S. So M equals KN. So N equals KM. It should be there. Okay. Is it possible? Let me write this as KM equals N. So I just exchange them. This is the first one, this is the second one, I'm going to divide them. M equals KN divided by this KN divided by N. MM gets cancelled. So you have 1 by K and this is K. Okay. Now there can be a logic that if K you have taken as 1 here and K can be 1 here also. But this is not for the general case. Right? That is why we are saying it to be not symmetric. It is not symmetric. Okay. Next one is transitive. Transitive we are checking. So M, N, let us take one more, say O. So this is equivalent to A and B and C which we have been taking. So M equals K N if it holds, N equals K into O if this holds, then M equals K into O should hold. First and second, if we assume it to be correct, then the third have to be there. So M equals KO, we have to find out whether it holds or not if first two conditions are there of a relation. So let us replace N because there is no N in the third one. So I'm just putting N as K into O. So I'm putting K as K and N as K into A. So K into K is what? This is again a constant. K into K is again a constant. Let us say that it is capital K. It is a constant only. M equals K into K into O. The K into K, let's assume it to be capital K. So M equals capital K into O. Okay. So this is K into K. I'm just assuming it to be some constant. So we are getting M equals to some constant into O. Basically K we have taken. So it's also a constant. So this is a transitive relation. Show that the relation less greater than equal to on the relation R of all real numbers is reflexive and transitive but not symmetric. Okay. So the 13th one is this. So we have already seen a question like this. So let me just write it the way it should be. So we have a relation R where we have an ordered pair A comma B, where A B is belonging to the set of real number. And this A is greater than or equal to B. Okay. So let us do it here. We have already done this. So first we'll start with the reflexive. So A is greater than or equal to B. Yes. We are replacing B by A. So A is greater than or equal to A. A is not greater than or equal to A, but A is greater. It is not greater, but it is equal. So we assume it to be reflexive. This is reflexive because there are two conditions, greater than or equal. Second one, symmetric.
Now symmetric we have A greater than or equal to B, so B should be greater than or equal to A. Now this is not possible. See, if 3 is greater than or equal to 2, 2 is greater than or equal to 3, this is not possible, right? So we just say that R is not symmetric. Coming to the third one. Now A is A, B, C we are taking. A is greater than or equal to B, B is greater than or equal to C. So it's quite obvious A should be greater than or equal to C. So this is the third we need from it. Either you can, by judging also, by observation also, it is true. But you can also take some number just to say strengthen your argument. So let us take 4, the 6, 4 and 2. So 6, 4 and 2. So 6 is greater than or equal to 4. So no, 6 is less than or equal to 4. 4 is less than or equal to 2. So 2 is greater than or equal to 4. 4 is greater than or equal to 6. Less than or equal to 6. Okay. Question number 14 it is. Now this is an NCERT question. In most of the book, it is given as question number 16. Somewhere it is 14. So the question is, give an example of a relation which is. So you have A, B. Then A is related to A, then the relation is reflexive. When we have A related to B and B related to A, that is going to, the relation is going to be symmetric. And when we have, this is the second one. When we have A, B, C, A is related to B, B is related to C. So A is related to C, that is going to be, it is going to be transitive. So we'll use this logic here. And since we have to give an example, so we'll start with a very small example, which is A equals 1, 2, 3. A equals 1, 2, 3. So it has to be reflexive. It has to be symmetric but not transitive. So I'm taking set as 1, 2 and 3. Now please watch very closely. See, if it has to be reflexive, it has to have 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is making this relation reflexive. Now if you take 1, 2, you have to take 2, 1. If you take 1, 2, similarly if you take 2, 3, you have to take 3, 2 to make it symmetric. So I'm adding one more. 3, 2 is not there, but I'm just adding it. It is including 3, 2. So transitive, see, 1, 2, 2, 3 is there. You see, in this set, we have 1, 2 and 2, 3, but there is no 1, 3. If 1, 2, 2, 3 is there, we need to have 1, 3 also. This is, for being transitive, we need to have 1, 3 also, which is not there. That is, this set is reflexive, symmetric, but not transitive. Now coming to the second one, reflexive and transitive but not symmetric. Reflexive and transitive but not symmetric. Okay. So A is 1, 2, 3. So 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, of course, it is reflexive. Now symmetric, it should not be there. So if we just write 1, 1, 1, 2, 1, 3 and 2, 3, we have added extra. Just, you know, 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is reflexive. Now see here, 1, 2, 2, 3. So 1, 3 should be there and it is there. 1, 2, 2, 3, 1, 3 is there, so it is transitive. But 1, 2, 2, 1 is not there. 1, 3, 3, 1 is not there. 2, 3, 3, 2 is not there, so it is not symmetric. It is not symmetric. Third one is symmetric and transitive but not reflexive. Okay. So 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 should not be there because otherwise it will be reflexive. We don't want it to be reflexive. Now, how it is symmetric and transitive? See, 1, 2 is there, 2, 1 is there. 1, 3 is there, 3, 1 is there. 2, 3 is there, 3, 2 is there. So, you have to, I'm just going to add the 3, 2 also. Okay, so just add 3, 2, then the answer will be correct. So, it is not reflexive. Symmetric, it is clear. How it is transitive? Let us take, say, 1, 3 and 1, 3 and 3, 1. No, you take 1, 2 and 2, 3. I'm taking 1, 2 and 1, 2 and 2, 3. So 1, 2 and 2, 3 if I take, that is A, B and B, C, 1, 3 should be there. 1, 2, 2, 3. 1, 3 should be there and 1, 3 is there. So that is how it is. Transitive also. A, B, B, C, A, C should be there. So it is transitive. So 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 we haven't taken because we don't want to be reflexive. Symmetric we have to, whatever we take, we have to have the opposite also. And transitive is that if 2 are there, you know, A, B, B, C, A, C should be there. So 1, 2, 2, 3 also prove that. Okay. Now you take 3, 1, 1, 2, one more example you can take. So 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, 2 should be there. 3, 2 is also there. 3, 2 I have added, okay. Next is symmetric but neither reflexive nor transitive. Symmetric but neither reflexive nor transitive.
So 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 3, 3, 1 is clear that it is symmetric. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is not there, so it is not reflexive. So 1, 2, 2, 1, 1, 1 is not there. 1, 3, 3, 1, 1, 1 is not there. Okay. Transitive, we have to have AB. If we have AB and BC, we should have AC. So if we have 2, 1, say 1, 3, we need to have 2, 3. Do we get 2, 3? No, we don't have 2, 3. That is why it is not transitive. Fifth, transitive but neither reflexive nor symmetric. Transitive but neither reflexive nor symmetric. Okay. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. So why it is not reflexive? Because we don't have 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. It is not symmetric because 1, 2, 2, 1 is not there. 2, 3, 3, 2 is not there. 1, 3, 3, 1 is not there. How it is transitive? 1, 2, 2, 3, A, B, B, C. 1, 3 is there. 1, 2, 2, 3. 1, 2, 2, 3. So we have 1, 3. And it is there. So this is how this relation can be made. Okay. 3, 2, 3, 2 should be there in first and third. Okay, I have added it. Question number 15. Now, the question number 15, most of the book, you see, this is question number 15. Actually, it is question number 14. So, if whichever addition you have, you can just see the question, you will understand. So, the relation is like this. We have a relation which is 1, 2, 3. This is a set A equals 1, 2, 3. The relation is 1, 2, 2, 3. The set is A, which is 1, 2, 3. And the relation is 1, 2, 2, 3. Add a minimum number of ordered pairs so that the enlarged relation is symmetric, transitive and reflexive. Okay. So let us start with the reflexive. Since we have 1, 2, 3, in order to make it reflexive, we have to have 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. So 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 3 should be there. So 1, 1. This is 1, 2, 2, 2, 3 is already given. So we are not adding, this is already there. We are adding 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. This we have to add to make it reflexive. Okay, done. Now, coming to the symmetric. What is symmetric? Symmetric is 1, 2, 2, 1 should be there. So just write 2, 1. 2, 3 is there. So you need 2, 3. You need 3, 2. So just add 3, 2. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3 is already there. So we have made it as symmetric also. So reflexive, we added 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3. For symmetric, we added 2, 1, 3, 2. Now we have this transitive. So this is 1, 3. Why we need 1, 3? Because see, 1, 2 is there, 2, 3 is there. So 1, 3 should be there. Similarly, we have 3, 3 and 3, 2. So 3, 2 is already there. 1, 1, 2, 2, 3. So 1, 3 we have added. And if we add 1, 3, we have to have 3, 1 also. Because 1, 3, 3 will 1 because we need symmetric also. So this is the part we need to add to make it as all the 3. Now this is question number 16. Now what do you see here? Again, this is question number 15 in some book, in some books 16, because in my edition it is question number 15. So the question is saying, given the relation R equals 1, 2, 1, 1, 2, 3, and the set is 1, 2, 3. So 1, 1, 2, 3 be a relation on A. What minimum number of ordered pairs may be added to R so that it may become a transitive relation on A? So we have to make it as a transitive. Just think about transitivity. So see, 1, 2 is there, 2, 3, 1, 1 is already, you know, transitive. 1, 2, 2, 3. So we need 1, 3. A, B, B, C, we need AC. 1, 2, 2, 3. We need 1, 3 here. Okay, done. Only 1, 3 you have to add. This 1, 3 has to be added. Okay. These are 16 questions. There are other questions also. If you have a certain other addition, these are some certain added questions which I am just displaying so that you can just stop and just go through this question, try to solve it. Any problem, just let me know. We can work upon it together. Okay, I'm just going through it. So these kind of questions we have already done, right? Okay, this is all about this exercise. Thank you so much. Take care of yourself.